This interactive simulation that demonstrates relatively complicated behavior of how fugacity changes with temperature. So if we look at a snapshot of fugacity as a function of temperature for a given overall mole fraction, and this is ideal solution, benzene, toluene. And the idea is the point here represents the condition that we can see on the TXY diagram. So when we move the temperature, it'll move the point on this graph. It'll also move the point on the TXY diagram. And we have the option of observing both of them at the same time, but just in a compressed format. The thing to note is that, for example, we look at component B here, benzene. As we raise the temperature, this is in the liquid phase, then the fugacity is increasing exponentially because the fugacity is the liquid phase mole fraction, which in this case is 0.65, times the saturation pressure. And the saturation pressure is increasing exponentially with temperature. We then get into the two-phase region, and now notice that the fugacity is decreasing, whereas the fugacity of the toluene is increasing. And this is because the mole fraction in the liquid phase of benzene is decreasing because it has a higher saturation pressure. And then eventually we get to this region, which is the vapor phase. And in the vapor phase, the fugacity, since we're assuming ideal gases, the fugacity is just a mole fraction, 0.65 times the total pressure, 1 bar. The idea of this simulation is better understand fugacities of individual components, keeping in mind that when we have vapor-liquid equilibrium, the fugacity of benzene in the liquid phase is equal to the fugacity of benzene in the vapor phase, and likewise for toluene. So if we now look at the interactive simulation, we can see the other curves and better understand this behavior. So here in the interactive simulation, we're looking at how the fugacity of the two components change as we raise the temperature. I can move the overall mole fraction, and those rather dramatic differences as I change the overall mole fraction. But in all cases, the fugacity of B increases at the lower temperature when it's a liquid. In the two-phase region, the fugacity of B decreases, and the fugacity of T, toluene, increases in this two-phase region as we raise the temperature. And we can see what's happening a little easier. And I can show you first, just to pick the temperature, we can see the behavior of the dot, and this dot corresponds to where we are here as we change the temperature. We're in the liquid regime, and now as we change the temperature, notice that the mole fraction of B is decreasing in both the gas and the liquid, and as a result, the fugacity is decreasing. And then once I get in the gas phase raising the temperature, I'm not changing the pressure. Fugacity is the total pressure times the mole fraction. I'm not changing the mole fraction, so fugacity doesn't change. So when I look at this, the fugacity is not changing as I raise the temperature in the gas phase region. I can look at both of these graphs together. Things are a little more squeezed together, but hopefully looking at both helps you understand the behavior that we're seeing. And particularly as we change the mole fractions, you see rather significant differences between the benzene and the toluene fugacities as a function of temperature. So the idea here is to give you a better understanding of fugacity and what it corresponds to. Of course, for an ideal gas, fugacity is just the partial pressures. For a liquid, the fugacity is the saturation pressure times the liquid mole fraction for ideal solution.